In this video series, I plan to cover in moderate depth some of the driving concepts in today's tuning theory. Before I can do that, however, you need to know a little about standard tuning and some basic acoustics. Sound is waves of pressure that travel through the air. The rate at which the high and the low pressures alternate is referred to as the sound's frequency. Note that the word frequency, though often used synonymously with the word pitch, actually refers directly to how frequent the pressure oscillations are. Frequency is measured in a unit called hertz, which denotes the number of oscillations per second. When those high and low pressure waves make contact with our eardrum, it flexes in accordance with those waves and sends that information to the brain. This is where frequency, a measurable phenomenon, becomes pitch, a subjective experience. The pitch of a note refers to how high or low it sounds, and changes in pitch, aka intervals, are measured in a unit called cents, where there are 1200 cents per octave. Pitch and frequency are related logarithmically, meaning that linear changes in pitch, like going up an octave, are actually multiplications of frequency. Octaves specifically are a doubling of frequency. For instance, from 400 to 800 Hz is heard as an octave, and so is from 800 Hz to 1600 Hz, because each is a multiplication by 2. Western music uses a collection of pitches that divides the octave into 12 equal parts, 100 cents each, makes all intervals multiples of 100 cents. This is only one option, however, out of an infinite number of possible ways to choose what intervals to include in your music. That is to say, it is only one possible tuning among an infinite number of tunings. This 12-tone equal tuning is so ubiquitous in the West, however, that most musicians are unaware that it has a name and that alternatives even exist. Up next, we dive into a fundamental concept in the world of tuning, just intonation.